Mobile phone consumption refers to the wastage of energy from a circuit or electrical line, also known as drain. This energy can be lost normally or abnormally depending on the configuration and modifications made. Normal consumption is reflected in the on and off of the screen, connection to Wi-Fi, putting music on the device, and similar things. On the other hand, abnormal consumptions refer to the waste of energy without proper use, such as a circuit failure. This can manifest itself in various forms, such as the phone not turning on, battery running low quickly, turning on and off, slow charging, and excessive heating. We always have a lot of problems when the consumption is not enough to turn on the screen, with the consumption of up to 200 or 250 milliamperes. These small consumptions gives us headaches. We always should ask the customer how the failure happened, any impact, water damage, or anything else. In mobile devices, it's possible to have the RAM memory on top of the CPU, such as AMMC or UFC memory. These memories are an alternative to traditional storage methods and offer faster access speed and better durability. This allows for a better user experience by being able to access information faster and without interruptions. More than that, these memories are more efficient when it comes to energy consumption, resulting in better battery life. In the schematic manuals, we can find the PMIC in two ways. First, we can find the PMIC with all its inputs, outputs, and different functions together. For example, here we have the U401 with this future. In the second option, we can find the PMIC divided by means of interference. In our case, it is divided into three interfaces. We go back to the previous schematic diagram. This means that our PMIC is divided into partitions. On the one hand, we have the boost inputs. On the other hand, we have the buck outputs. On another, we have the LDO outputs. And finally, we have other functions such as the power button, the volume, the flash, the camera, the audio, and similar things. To simplify it even more, I put a color to each sector. If one of our four sectors is short circuit or has leaks, it is likely that the device will not work. Some sectors can be checked without raising the PMIC, and other sectors it isn't possible. For example, in these capacitors, it is possible to know if these lines are working correctly only by measuring with the help of the tester. The same happens with these inductors or bobbins. They can be perfectly measured next to the PMIC. Other sectors cannot be checked because the lines go directly to the CPU or memory are under the layers. Practically, we have no test point. Here we have a diagram of the PMIC. On the left, we see the boost input line. For example, there are 6 input lines, which means that in the diagram there are 6 capacitors to measure the input voltage. On the upper right there are 6 buck outputs, which constitute the output lines of the PMIC. To determine how many inputs there are, the bobbins or inductors must be searched, which have a larger size and can be perfectly appreciated in the motherboard. In this way, we will be able to know how many inputs there are. If there are 10 buck outputs, then there are 10 input line or 10 capacitor. These inputs and outputs can be measured with precision in the bobbins and capacitors that are next to the PMIC. Below, to the right, there are other outputs that are the LDO. These outputs can be connected directly to the CPU, GPU, and memory. So, what's the difference between LDO line and the buck line? The buck converter is used to reduce the input voltage to a lower output, while the LDO regulator is used to maintain a constant output voltage. This LDO line can be used to power the device internal integrated circuits, such as the CPU, GPU, and memory. Finally, we have the lines of different functions such as the power button, the volume, the flash, the NFC antenna, the camera, and so on. Any PMIC inside is composed of several components such as diodes, regulators, MOSFET switches, transistors, and mini circuits. If one of these components is damaged, the entire circuit will stop working.